wow. Look at these apples. Someone must have started picking them, but forgot to grab these. What a strange place to leave an apple. Just right on the ground. Where'd that apple come from? Hello? Who's there? What on earth? These apples are just falling from this tree. That's awfully strange. I guess apples aren't the only things that fall from trees. Acorns, leaves, and even branches sometimes fall from trees too. Why do things fall? We know that objects in motion can move a lot of different ways. They can move up and down, back and forth, round and round, in a straight line, zigzag, and more. We also know that objects can fall. Let's quickly investigate what kind of motion falling might be. Go ahead and grab your pencil and hold it out in front of you, like this. On the count of three, we are going to drop it and observe how it moves. Ready? One, two, three. What did you notice? I noticed that my pencil fell in a straight line all the way to the floor. But I still have the question of why things fall. I know that apple fell out of the tree in a straight line, but what made it fall? A force is needed to put an object in motion. But I didn't see anyone or anything pushing or pulling the apple. That can mean only one thing. We are dealing with an invisible force. Gravity is an invisible force that pulls everything toward the earth beneath our feet. This force is what causes objects to fall down toward the ground. Gravity is the reason we stay on the ground and don't just float away into the sky. When I jump, I push myself up with my legs, and then gravity pulls me back down to the ground. When I toss this ball into the air, it falls back down into my hand. When you slide down a slide, gravity is pulling you down. You can't see it, but gravity is pulling on everything on Earth all the time. Without gravity, we would be weightless, similar to how astronauts feel when they appear to be floating in space. Something important to remember about gravity is that it is acting equally on everything all the time. That means that gravity is using the same amount of force to pull me and this elephant to the ground. Let me show you an example. I have a poppet and a basketball here. This basketball is definitely heavier and bigger than this poppet. If I hold the ball and the poppet at the same height and drop them at the same time, which do you think will hit the ground first? All right, let's find out. What did you see? The poppet and the basketball hit the ground at the exact same time. That's because gravity is pulling them both with equal force. It doesn't matter that the basketball is heavier, it's going to fall at the same speed as the poppet. It's pretty cool, huh? Gravity has the ability to put objects in motion by pulling on them, but it can also make objects stop. Watch what gravity does to stop this ball from moving. When I throw it, gravity is pulling it down toward the earth. And once it hits the ground, it'll roll and bounce a few times before gravity pulls it to a complete stop. If I threw this ball without any gravity, it would continue moving in the direction I threw it until someone or something was able to stop it. That would be a football star. It looks like gravity is what's holding me back from being a superstar football player. So, why do apples and everything else fall? Objects on Earth fall because of an invisible force called gravity. Gravity is constantly pulling on everything. We just can't feel it. Just like the apples in the tree, gravity puts them in motion by pulling them to the ground. Gravity also pulls the apples to a stop once they fall to the ground. Gravity can do it all. Great job today, scientists. I'll see you next time, and remember, science is all around us. Hey.